As a kid, I was very focused on sports. My early career goals were that I wanted to be a mountain guide. But then I started thinking about medicine, and my idea was to become a clinical sports medicine doctor. When I was at Oxford, we had funding to go to a couple of remote mountains abroad. Because of that, I got invited to join a team of my heroes to go to the last unclimbed face on Mount Everest. While I was in Nepal, I found out the Nepali name for a blind person was a mouth with no hands. And when you're in a subsistence agrarian economy and you have a person who eats but doesn't contribute, it's a huge burden. And children don't go to school because they're taking care of a blind parent, a blind grandparent. People are lost to the workforce. People, once they go blind, just sort of shrivel up. They become depressed and look much older than their years. These are people who have completely treatable cataracts. I had the privilege of watching a Dutch team doing cataract surgery with lens implants. And after surgery, they just blossom back to life. I said, wow, this is exactly what I want to do. I made the decision to go into ophthalmology because it was a place I saw that I could actually have an impact in global medicine. 90% of the blind people on our planet are in the poorest developing countries, and 85% of that could be prevented or easily treated. So when I started working in Nepal, there was an estimated 200,000 blind people from cataracts, and only 15,000 cataract surgeries being performed each year. But we started out setting up systems to train eye surgeons. Now, 18 years later, doctors from Nepal are doing 250,000 cataract surgeries every year. So now I'm focusing more of my time and effort on Africa, where we're still in a situation similar to what we were in Nepal 15 years ago. I was in Nigeria teaching cataract surgery, and they brought me this girl. She was blind, sitting in the corner, and she was completely depressed and just completely withdrawn. I looked at her, and I saw she had a normal cornea in one eye and an intact retina in her cornea blind eye. So I was able to transplant her own cornea from her blind retina eye to the other cornea, and within a week, her life was transformed. She's finished high school, and she's studying to be a nurse in Nigeria. There's so many stories like that through the years, because once you do a cataract surgery on a blind person, they're restored back to their role in the family or back to work. I've been just so fortunate to interact with people who've never seen their grandchildren before, never seen their children before, and the joy of getting the sight back is something I never get tired of.